Okay, we're here with Sonic legend, Shawn Kemp. Shawn, just talk about when you first started playing basketball and how you got into it.
I'm from Indiana, so I started off playing basketball pretty early on. Back in Indiana, so I've pretty much been playing all my life. I've been around the game of basketball, and like, I was one of those kids that played all different sports, though. I tried to play all different sports, but basketball's always been in my heart and always been my favorite.
And how much did you say, once you knew it's something you're going to do, how much did you practice in your free time?
Growing up playing basketball, I didn't just start off being good, so it took a whole lot of practice. One of the things that I think made me advance in basketball is because I simply was able to learn the work ethic early on. And what I mean by that is that I wanted to be a little different than most guys in school, so I would go to school every year from my ninth grade year to my senior year. I went to school at 5:30 a.m. to work out with my coaches, just on post moves, fundamental footwork, just to kind of get a little edge on the rest of the players, just to work a little bit harder and get an edge.
And what age did you realize this is, you know, your passion, this is something you wanted to do, basketball?
Pretty early on, I think I started playing, like I said, I started playing for my school. I got some confidence there, and I actually started playing AAU basketball also. I started traveling when I was in sixth grade to places like Los Angeles, Las Vegas. I was able to win a couple of AAU national championships, which, kind of put me on a showcase a little bit where people got a chance to see me play more. And Nike got a chance to see me play more. And it gave me a chance to get out there and really just be competitive all around the world from the age of sixth grade through the remainder of high school.
And talk about some of the obstacles that you had to overcome just going into it, friends or different things that kind of got in the way.
Well, the first thing that got in the way was my grades. My grades got in the way simply because once I got into playing sports and stuff, I didn't realize that I was going to have to schedule things right. Basketball practice, homework, and it took me about a year and a half to get my grade situation right when I was in the eighth, ninth grade. And once I was able to get a better foundation down on spending time on my homework, working with my teachers, keeping a good relationship with them, the basketball stuff came pretty easy because I was able to organize the other little stuff. So I've always said the basketball become much more easier to me after I really put my concentration into school.
And just kind of being a big name, what's it feel like kind of have the city on your shoulders and just have to endure all that pressure?
Well, it can be tough, but I think the main thing is what you want to do. You know, you really want to pay a lot of respect to everybody, and you want to be as courteous as possible. And you want to have an understanding of knowing that everything is not just about you. One of the things I was able to do was just look upon and not say that, like, I'm the man. I never really felt that way. I think I always was trying to see how I could make other guys better and make myself better at the same time. And I think it really paid off because it made me more of a down-earth person, but it also taught me a lot of little things in life to just keep being respectful to everything that I do, whether it be in business, whether it be in professional basketball, whether it be with me dealing with the media or anything like that. It just was one of those things where it really kept me down to earth and made me realize that I could do other things than just play basketball.
And preparing for some of the big names like Jordan and Barkley, how did you prepare up against those big guys?
Oh, man, first of all, it was very scary. You know, I was a young kid when I first came into the NBA. I signed when I was 18, and I was able to play against Barkley and Jordan and those guys at a high level, you know, simply because of just concentration and work ethic. I was scared to death a lot of times playing against those guys, but I think a lot of times when you're scared in life, that's what you do, man. You challenge yourself to be even better, you know. And I just kept telling myself, run faster, do everything at a high level, a high speed, and then see where you are. And sometimes I miss, and I would mess up out there on the court at an early age. But I mean, I just stuck with doing everything real fast, real strong, reminding myself to be real confident out there, and you know, just hope for the best.
And they talk about how the greats practice the hardest. Just talk about your daily practice schedule and went into that off season, during season.
Yeah, I mean, the practice schedule is it becomes the most important thing when you're a professional basketball player, because you have to utilize your time and make sure that you're practicing on the right things. And what I mean by that is that, like, when I first came into the NBA, I wasn't a very good shooter. I don't think I was a very good passer. And there was a lot of little things that I just couldn't do. So you find out one or two things that you can really do, and you just do that. You don't try to handle the basketball when you can't handle the basketball. You don't try to shoot long jump shots when you can't do that. You try to get in close to make the most of your points by scoring layups and using the backboard, making things real simple. So early on, I was able to kind of define what couple things that I could do, and it was basically play defense and block shots.
And you're known a lot for your dunks. You talked a little bit about the story before. Just talk about the story, how you started dunking.
Yeah, I mean, I grew up, dunking was something that I had always marveled and looked at guys, and I loved Dr. J growing up. My favorite athlete was actually Jim Brown, who played for the Cleveland Browns. But I loved watching Dr. J dunk the basketball growing up. I never had a clue that I would be able to dunk the basketball quite well as Dr. J did, or even better if you want to look at it that way. I really got to slam dunking from the fans. I mean, a lot of that came from me just getting involved with the fans in the game, getting a reaction, being able to go up and make some plays at the end of games. And then I was able to get one dunk in, and then I said, you know what, I'm going to try to dunk even more and more and more. And it just got contagious, man. And it gave me a lot of confidence, and I think definitely made a connection with the fans. I think they could see the work, the hard work, the dedication that I put into trying to dunk the basketball, but also making them, you know, because you can try to dunk the basketball sometimes, but you miss them. So making them is very important.
Mistakes. Is there any mistakes you made that you can just tell kids, you know, something that they can learn from?
Oh, man, I've made all kinds of mistakes. You know, like I said, growing up, I had like a year and a half where I had to really check myself on grades after I got into the pros. When I got to the pros, I was young. I had a couple of kids, so I had to learn how to be more responsible. I had to learn how to protect myself. I really just tried to, and still to this day, I really just try to better myself. I try to look at things, simplify things, look around and see little ways that I can better myself, regardless if it's in business, regardless if it's in life. And I think the one thing that, if I can say anything to the kids, is that don't be afraid of making a mistake. Only be afraid of repeating a mistake that you've made. When you continually make a mistake, that's a problem. But sometimes we try things to make a mistake, but you have to learn from your mistake. As long as you do that, then I think you'll be better.
And do you have any hobbies growing up other than basketball?
Yeah, absolutely, man. I mean, growing up, I grew up playing the saxophone. Playing the saxophone growing up. I still love music. I used to design tennis shoes when I was in elementary school, like just on papers, and it wasn't computers at this time, so it was really just drawing and sketching out sneakers and shoes, which is what. So I was able to, I've been working with Reebok for over 20 years now, being able to design some shoes and stuff. So a lot of my dreams became true, man, just because, you know, I just kept pushing myself and trying different things.
Do you have any favorite movies you watch with your kids or anything, or anything like that?
Absolutely, man. Me and my son, like once a month, we'll sit down and watch the Bad News Bears. Absolutely, one of my favorite movies.
Sweet. And any type of food or candy you like to eat on the side?
Oh man, I like cheesecake. My wife likes cheesecake. You know, we do a lot of family outings. We enjoy each other's time. I have three boys at home. I got one in college, and we're a pretty close family. We do a lot of cooking, a lot of barbecuing at the house, and we try to spend a lot of time with each other, not just to pass time, but also just to educate the kids on how to take care of themselves, how to how to make meals and different things like that around the house.
And if there, you said this stuff about mistakes, is there any advice you can give the kids just about, you know, following their dreams, achieving their dreams?
Well, I think if you can think of it, you can achieve it. And the kids have to challenge themselves to dream and try to achieve those biggest dreams as possible. That's the only way that you're going to accomplish something. Sometimes when you don't give yourself a chance to accomplish something, you don't get there because you're not dreaming big. So there's nothing wrong with dreaming big. There's nothing wrong with trying to be the president. There's nothing wrong with trying to get into the NBA. There's nothing wrong with trying to be a doctor, a lawyer. There's nothing wrong with trying to do any of those things. I think as a kid, when I was a kid, I had all those dreams, man. I'm sitting around, and basketball was just one of them. So it was just, it's one of those things where you just get out, you got to work your butt off, and you never know what's going to happen. You got to give yourself a chance to grow. And I think, I think I've done that throughout the years in the best way that I possibly can.
Here's Shawn Kemp. Shawn Kemp, thanks. Really appreciate it.
Oh, thank you.